Hello, everyone. So, after a fair old while, Chameleon Launcher has finally come to mobile phones. Now, if you might remember, Chameleon Launcher was a Kickstarter project, one of the earliest ones to be first funded. And they created a new launcher for tablets. And it was okay. It wasn't brilliant or anything. I've always found it a bit limited compared to some of the other launchers out there. But it's now come out for smartphones, so available for any kind of Android phone device. Ideally, you're going to want a 720p screen to get the best out of this. But the idea is it provides customizable home screens effectively. So you can have these home screens which have these very beautiful widgets provided by Chameleon on there. Or you can just use your normal Android widgets as well. But the idea is it provides a kind of customizable home screen that's a bit more slick than the usual Android one. And you can also have it based on conditions. So you can have a set of home screens which are for work use and a set of home screens for home or whatever you like. You can set them anywhere you like. So first we're gonna show you how to add some widgets. So you long press on the screen and you get this bar and you go to widgets. And these are the Chameleon widgets that they've created. And slightly disappointingly, they haven't made a lot of progress on the widget front over the last, well, year really. Pretty basic, and it would have been nice to see more widgets coming through. There is a make a widget option, and they give you lots of instructions on their developer docs on how you can make your own, but it doesn't seem developers are really bothering, which is a real pity. There's such a great opportunity here to create these new style of really gorgeous widgets. It's a shame that we've really only got the usual suspects really. Twitter, Facebook, Gmail, Google+, Instagram, a calendar, quick access to switches, time, weather, YouTube, woo. And then obviously you can pull in your traditional widgets from Android as well if you want to, which helps to boost things up a little bit. But, you know, it means that you're kind of dealing with a mismatch of Android-y widgets and Chameleon-y style widgets. It's a bit of a shame. But let's just go in and we'll add a Google+. You can draw it out across these six square areas to create the size of widget you want. So there's no mass changing that allows you to absolutely position it pixel by pixel. It always snaps to the grid, which is a bit of a shame, but that's how it works. So that's one widget added. We'd click on the top there, go to there, and we then add the feed. And it will then pull that feed in. You can long press again. Oops. Which then brings you back into here and you can then rescale it if you want to, which is quite nice. You've got the wallpaper controls as well. If we come down here onto this bottom bar, this is where we can then set these home screens and create conditions for them. So if I add a new home screen and set a condition, I can then say at a certain time or when on a particular Wi-Fi network or by a location marker, change to this home screen effectively. So if I was to say weekdays, or should I say weekends on Saturday, between starting at say, 8 o'clock, and go. And what the system will do is when it detects that time has been hit, it will change the system over automatically to show you the other set of home screens. It's a really cool idea, and it's something I would love to see Google kind of adopt generally, actually, that we do need this ability to be able to kind of go, well, no, I'm in work mode, now I'm in home mode, or any variation therein, and have that kind of flexibility within the Android operating system. At a launch level, it is done very, very well by Chameleon. It works nicely and it feels fluid, more importantly. The whole package with Chameleon is very, very slickly done. Whether this is the kind of launcher you're going to want to use as your daily driver, I think that really comes down to personal choice. For me, I find it just a little bit too limited, in part because whilst the Chameleon widgets look awesome, absolutely awesome, the moment you then start trying to mix it with non-Chameleon widgets, things fall apart quite quickly and it becomes a cluttered, messy interface. Down at the bottom here, you have your quick dock and also access to all your applications on there as well. Like I say, as you can see, it's a very, very fast and fluid launcher. On the smartphones, I think it works really well. I wasn't a massive fan of it on tablets. I thought it actually got in the way more than it helped. But on smartphones, yes, it's quite nice. It's quite nicely done, and it makes quite good use of the real estate that you actually have. On smartphones, like I say, these widgets ended up feeling just a bit too bloated and in the way. But on a smartphone, it actually feels quite nice. It almost feels like Chameleon is better suited to the smartphones than it maybe is to the tablets. But that's Chameleon Launcher. Give it a try. It's available for smartphones for $2.99, I believe. If you previously bought it for tablets, you can use the tablet edition and just install it on your phone. You don't have to pay twice, which I think was a really smart move on Chameleon's part. So like I say, if you just want the smartphone version, a couple of quid. If you already own the tablet version, download the tablet version to your smartphone and you get Chameleon for smartphone straight away. No additional purchase. So that's Chameleon Launcher.